Umahlabekufeni is what they call it in these parts. Croton gratissimus is what I call it. You can call it whatever you want. In English, it's usually known as the lavender croton. How's it, guys? I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. I'm on a little walkabout here through the wilds of Western Wanga National Park, all Mapani scrub, very typical of this area, right on the edge of the Kalahari Desert, staying in a stunning lodge, a newly refurbished Nantwich Lodge, which is right on top of a hill overlooking a pan, former national parks, lodges that have now been put under new management and completely redone, looking really beautiful. They practically haven't had any visitors yet because they just opened just before COVID, so that's fresh and spick and span. Highly recommended. This part of the park, Wangi's, much less visited than the eastern part, so if you really want to get away from it all, absolutely the place to go. And we were just walking through the bush and I saw this, and I just love this plant. I think this is one of the most interesting plants around, and I've often wanted to do a story on it and never done one, so I'm just happy to be able to do it now. So what's so special about the lavender croton? Well, firstly, you can see these enormously discolorous leaves. So it's really striking in the bush. You see this dark green on the outside and then this kind of almost white on the inside. If you look very closely through a lens, or even with a naked eye, you'll notice underneath that there are all these little golden glands as well, very distinctive. And if you're still not sure when you come across it, all you gotta do is crush the leaves, take a big deep breath, and then you will be in absolutely no doubt. Very fragrant, beautifully aromatic, quite a kind of unique fragrance actually. So the lavender bush has, the lavender croton, sorry, has been used often to make a kind of a lavender water. So you just soak the leaves in water and then take it off afterwards. A few different applications for it, but it's just a beautiful smelling water that you might want to put around places to make it smell a bit nicer. It's called, in Afrikaans, it's called the Kosbesi, which means the fever berry, and that of course implies traditional uses treating fever. But it's not just the Afrikaners that have traditional uses for it. Wherever it's found in Southern Africa, there's a wide range of traditional uses associated with it. Called by the San Bushmen in the Kalahari region, Botswana, they call it Makwasi. It is used firstly medicinally. The leaves are used, leaf extracts particularly used to treat coughs. The bark is used medicinally for a wide range of applications, from fevers, coughs, chest complaints, also going through to rheumatism. A little bit toxic, so I definitely do not advise you to self-medicate without any supervision. The croton is part of the euphorbia family, and of course we know that with euphorbias there are a lot of toxic compounds in them. Also quite pharmacologically active, the croton family have a couple of compounds that are unique to them. One's called crotonin, one's called crotofolin. I don't know if they're in this one specifically, but they are in a number of the crotons, and there is quite a bit of knowledge around their traditional use. There are some pharmacological applications relating to this plant, both in terms of topical application and inhaled or inhalations. But I, as I said, I don't recommend that you try any of this at home because it's not necessarily terribly safe. But it is a beautiful plant. It's got quite distinctive little berries. They're not big, they're not shiny, but they're quite noticeable. The flowers are fairly sort of nondescript yellow color, but it's always these discolorous leaves as you walking through the bush that immediately draws your eye to them and tells you that is a lavender croton. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, there's plenty more on my YouTube channel and Facebook and Instagram. Just type in African Plant Hunter. You'll find me, hit that subscribe button, and you'll never go shy again. And if you are wanting to come to this far, far western part of Wangi National Park, I'd really recommend you check out Nantwich. It's newly opened and many people like myself will have fond memories of it back in the day and will be delighted to come and find it restored not only to its previous glory but even above that. So check it out. And I hope to see you again, guys. I'm going to head out and check out some other plants in this area. I'm in plant hunting heaven. All right, take it easy. Bye.